My greetings and warm welcome to all the viewers. In today's video, we will be familiar with the guidelines for laying the paver blocks on pavement. In this video, we will see where paver blocks are placed, what are its advantages and limitations, the type and shape of the block will also be discussed. The main focus of this video will be on the composition, a structural design and construction of the block pavement. Interlocking concrete block pavement have been found to have application in several situations such as footpaths and sidewalks, car parks, rural road through villages, fuel stations, residential streets, bus depots. Paver block is used in many places due to its numerous advantages. The biggest advantage is that block pavement greatly reduces the speed of the vehicles, due to which there is a lot of reduction in the accident on the roads. In India, the concrete block pavement can be obtained at a low cost due to the availability of cheap labor. Because of the rough surface, these pavements are skid resistant. Hence, these pavements are unaffected by the spillage of oil from vehicles and ideal for bus stops, bus depot and parking areas. Maintenance of block pavement is simple and easy. The cost of maintenance is much lower than that of a bituminous or rigid pavement. The block pavement does not require much time for its construction, and hence it can be open to traffic soon after completion of construction. Since every coin has its two sides, similarly, block pavement has few limitations along with its many advantages. Concrete block pavement cannot be used for high speed facilities. The surface of the paver block is very rough, hence the friction of the wheels caused by the movement of vehicles makes a lot of noise. A very good attention to pavement drainage is needed because the water can seep through the joints and the entire pavement may fail. Depending on the interlocking condition, the paver block is fractionated into three categories. In category A, blocks are of designs in which they are connected to other blocks with all four of their sides. Whereas in category B, the blocks can only be interlocked with other blocks from two sides. The category C blocks are not dented type but depend on dimensional accuracy for interlocking effect. The overall dimension of blocks used in different parts of the world are as follows. Except for the top wearing part of the pavement, the base and subbase layers are similar to the conventional flexible or rigid pavement. In general, block pavement is comprises of four layers, which are subgrade, base and subbase, sand bedding and the surface course, that is blocks. A few typical composition normally used are given in these two figures. The first figure depicts a typical cross section of block pavement used in sidewalks, footpaths, car parks, cycle track, and the second figure is a typical cross section of block pavement for heavily traffic roads. Interlocking concrete blocks comes in different thickness. These blocks serve as a wearing surface but at the same time help in reducing the stresses imposed on the subgrade and also help in resisting pavement deformation and elastic deflections similar to the base course of a flexible pavement. A block thickness of 60 mm is sufficient for light traffic such as pedestrian, motor car, bicycle, etc. For medium traffic, a thickness of 80 mm is commonly used. For heavy traffic roads, block thickness of 100 to 120 mm is used. A layer of sand bedding is provided between block and base or subbase for some reasons, like to provide a cushion between the hard base and the paving blocks. The base or subbase will have some permitted surface unevenness. By providing a layer of the sand bed, the paved block can be leveled perfectly. The sand bed acts as a barrier and does not allow propagation of cracks formed in base or subbase. A layer thickness of 20 to 40 mm is found to be satisfactory. Two types of sands are used in the construction of block pavements. One is for sand bed and the other is for block jointing. The grading and quality of sand are very important for the block pavement to perform satisfactorily. The sand used should be free from plastic clay and should be angular type. The bed of sand should not be so thick that it is difficult to control the surface level. Joints between blocks are filled with fine sand. Normally, the bottom 20 to 30 mm of the joints gets filled with bedding sand, whereas the remaining space has to be filled with jointing sand by brooming it from the top. The joints are normally 2 to 4 mm wide. Base and subbase layers are the important structural layer of a block pavement. The material used for base construction consists of either bond material like lean concrete or soil cement or bituminous layer, or unbound material like wet mix magnum or water bound magnum. The subbase layer is usually of granular material such as stone pebbles. The subbase layer can also act as a drainage layer. Concrete blocks on traffic pavement tend to move sideways and forward due to braking and improper driving of vehicles. Special blocks and curbs are required to be placed on both sides of the pavement to prevent the tendency to move sideways of the blocks. The edge blocks are to be made of concrete of high strength to withstand the traffic wheel loading without getting damaged. This member should have at least a 28-deck compressive strength of 30 MPa or flexural strength of 3.8 MPa. Design procedures have been developed by agencies abroad based on successful performance or mechanistic principles. They cover a variety of roads ranging from the lightly trafficked to the heavily trafficked. In the absence of research, it is recommended that the catalog of designs given subsequently may be used. Pedestrians, sidewalks, footpaths, cycle tracks, car parks, and malls are lightly trafficked. In such situations, the pavement can consist of blocks 60 mm thick, laid over sand bedding 20 to 30 mm and a base course of 200 mm thick. The block pavement is not a waterproof layer due to the sand-filled joint, and the water finds its way down to the sand bedding, base and subgrade. Therefore, a special attention is required to get the water out. Otherwise, it can ruin the entire pavement. A cross fall of 2% slope is generally sufficient to drain the surface runoff, but it is desirable to provide 3% crossfall in case of heavily traffic roads to avoid formation of water puddles. The construction of the block pavement goes through various processes. First, the soil subgrade is constructed, then the base and subbase, then sand bedding, and finally the block is laid. For the construction of block pavement, first of all, the soil subgrade is prepared. This layer serves as the foundation for the block pavement. Like conventional pavements, the water table should be at a minimum depth of 600 mm below the subgrade. Soil subgrade should be compacted in layers of 150 or 100 mm thickness as per IRC 36. After the completion of soil subgrade compaction, base and subbase layers are laid. Constructing the layers to proper level and grade is very essential to maintain the level and surface regularity of the block pavement. The layer that is laid just over the subbase is called sand bedding. The thickness of the sand bed after compaction should be in the range of 20 to 40 mm. The sand used should be uniform in loose condition and should have uniform moisture content. The best moisture content is when the sand is neither too wet nor too dry and has a value of 6 to 8%. The processed sand is spread evenly over the base layer to the required thickness with the help of screed board. Level checks shall be carried out to establish that the desired level is achieved. Local correction can be done either by removing or adding extra sand, followed by leveling and compacting the layers. Blocks can usually be laid by manual labor. After the leveling of sand, the blocks are embedded using a hammer. Normally, laying should commence from the edge strip and proceed towards the inner side. On a sloping side, laying of blocks start from the lowest point and proceed uphill on a continuous basis to avoid downhill creep in incomplete areas. For compaction of the bedding sand and the blocks laid over it, vibratory plate compactors are used over the laid paving units. At least two passes of the vibratory plate compactors are needed. After the compaction of the bedding sand has been completed, the joints should be completely filled with sand meeting the desired specification. The process of joint filling comprises of spreading a thin layer of the joint filling sand on the block surface and spreading the sand into each joint by brooming. The best advantage of block pavement is that it does not take any time to curing and settlement after completion of work. The traffic is opened soon after the work is completed. I hope you have learned a lot about laying of paver blocks from this video. We will meet soon in the next video with another civil engineering related topics. Till then, take care of yourself. Jai Hind!